Hello, everybody. Welcome to World Peace Pro Wrestling Season 5. Tonight, we crank up the criticals because it's Kentucky Knuckleberry Jam. Coming into tonight, Tom Nakano has been booked for The Last Dance, and Taiji Ishimori is earmarked for retirement at the end of the season. Also, for the first time ever, we have a tie for first place in the Season 5 rankings between Bull Nakano and The Bear. A couple of big matches tonight, including World Peace Pro rookie Buddy Rogers challenges The Bear for the Sloan Championship. Rogers has been focused on the Sloan title since joining World Peace Pro. His wife's maiden name is Sloan, and he won't have anyone dragging that name through the dirt sheets. He actually had an unsuccessful shot at the title at the beginning of the season. He took The Bear to her longest singles match ever, 19 minutes, 23 seconds for a 96% rating. Tonight, we get Rogers versus Bear, the sequel. Also this evening, Tom Nakano has an opportunity to form a brand new stable. To be successful, she'll have to defeat a roster member of her choosing. If she wins, her opponent will join her under a brand new banner. If she loses, her momentum will be reset to zero and she'll have to start the climb all over again. The rules state that she can only challenge wrestlers currently not holding a title belt. Eligible candidates include ACH, Io Shirai, Randy Savage, wow, former Grand Champion Randy Savage, Nyla Rose, but Nakano has chosen as her potential stablemate from Dog Vision, El Hijo del Vikingo. Will we see a new stable born? Speaking of stables, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. The big story coming into tonight continues to be the market's struggles. Their momentum is sitting at a frightening negative 9. Momentum, of course, goes up and down with wins and losses, and any stable who ends an event with momentum at negative 10 will enter crisis mode. There will be blood. I mean, most likely. Most likely there will be blood. Aside from The Bear, three other members of the market are in action tonight. Enhancement talent Bert Fink is challenging embattled rookie Nyla Rose. Bull Nakano comes calling for Tenzan's historic Abbotsford Championship. And in our main event, former market stable member Bryant Big Country Reeves will challenge market leader Warren Buffett for the Kelowna Heavyweight Championship. But first, Joe Exotic looks to pad Dog Vision's record by taking on volunteer firefighter Dave Boudreaux in his Season 5 debut. A reminder, you can watch all of the matches uncut and without commentary by following the links in the description. Otherwise, we'll be looking at highlights only in 3, 2, 1... Big Dave lasts 15 minutes in the ring with Joe Exotic, but it comes with a hefty price. Dave is officially injured in the match, but thankfully he is expected to return without issue. This is Big Dave's second injury in a World Peace Pro. Joe Exotic just absolutely painted the mat with this guy's blood. Yikes, a 70% rating overall. Next up, we have the newly formed tag team of Dragon Rojo Jr. and Natsuko Tora. They need a name, so if you guys are feeling creative and you want to drop a suggestion in the comments, that would be super. They will be taking on the team of Enhancement Talents Boris Antonov and Jose Coronado. If Rojo and Tora win, they'll be able to challenge for the tag team titles. As expected, Rojo Jr. and Tora come out on top, but let's not discount the great performance from their opponents. Tora takes it with a spinning arm slam in 15 minutes, 4 seconds for a pretty solid 79% rating. In our third match of the evening, Bam Bam Bigelow takes on ACH. Their previous matches have averaged an 89% rating, so expect a strong performance here in Bigelow's first ever World Peace Pro match. He fought and suffered an injury at the hands of ACH tonight. Bigelow looks to return the favor, and with the increased critical rate, he might just succeed. What a swerve. Bam Bam Bigelow is injured at the hands of ACH again. A second time by ACH. 450 splash. And this is the second injury this season, which is very bad news for Bigelow. Any wrestler who suffers two injuries in the same season will be out of action until the beginning of the following season. So Bam Bam is going to be out of commission until he recovers. We won't see him back until Flashing Lights Season 6. And on top of that, he's forced to vacate the Ferris Championship. You know what? I'm going to go forward here with a new rule. When a wrestler is sidelined with a season-ending injury, if they are a heel, they adopt a new goal to retire the wrestler that injured them. That means ACH, there is a target on your back. Next up, leader of Coco Express, Cobra Moon, challenges Taiji Ishimori for the Cameron Championship. Moon looks to drive the knife deeper into the Bone Soldier, who needs to find a way to win the Season 5 Grand Championship in order to stave off retirement. At this point in the season, there are three pathways remaining for Ishimori: either win Flex Parade, win the Orion League, or finish the season as the top-ranked wrestler. Any one of those will get him booked for The Last Dance and an opportunity for the Grand Championship. Ishimori and Cobra Moon, absolute banger of a match. Ishimori retains in 13 minutes, 5 seconds with an 89% overall. That is the highest ranked match that these two have ever had. The fifth match of the evening, Kongo Kong put out an open challenge for the Kong Vision title, and leader of Ryubone, Ultimo Dragon, has answered the call. If Ultimo Dragon wins this match, he will leapfrog Kong and move from 11th overall in the rankings to 4th. Congo Kong just struts through Ultimo Dragon. Dragon barely gets in any offense at all. Kong takes it in just 8 minutes and 1 second with the Uproot German. I've never seen him use that move, and now he's won 2 matches in a row with it. What is happening? Oh, here we go. Next up, Bert Fink gets a rare opportunity to challenge a proper member of the roster, and he's made a very strategic choice in Nyla Rose. Rose has yet to pick up a win in World Peace Pro, having lost to Natsuko Tora, Bam Bam Bigelow, Brian Reeves, and Joe Exotic. She certainly appears to be the most vulnerable member of the roster. If any roster member loses a match to enhancement talent, they will be forced to put their career on the line at the next earliest booking opportunity. Considering the people who are lurking in the shadows, that would be very bad for Nyla Rose. Of course, that's just one element of this match. Rose is a member of the market, so if she loses here, not only will her career be on the line, but her stable momentum will move from negative 9 to negative 10, and they will have crossed the threshold into crisis mode. This would be a fantastic match to watch unedited. Check the description for the link. Otherwise, we'll get going in. Bert Fink wins. 11 minutes, 8 seconds. Only a 59%. What the hell? I'm on the edge of my seat the entire time. Okay, let's go through this slowly. So, what does this all mean? The market drops to negative 10. If they end Kentucky Knuckleberry Jam at negative 10 or worse, they are in crisis. Bad news for them. Nyla Rose lost to Enhancement Talent, so at our next event, she will be forced to put her career on the line. Again, against who, you might be asking? Tune in to Flex Parade to find out. And something that we didn't even mention before, if Enhancement Talent beats a true roster member, they will be sent on excursion at the end of the season and return between 1 to 10 seasons later as a full-fledged roster member. Bert Fink is going on excursion. There are 240 possible excursion destinations for Bert Fink. Should we do this now or part of the off-season special episode? Oh, I'm so excited, but we'll save the destination for the off-season special. That will be fun. Okay, next up. Oh, here we go. It's Buddy Rogers' second attempt at the Sloan Championship. He is a man motivated by old-timey sensibilities. You know he smokes. Church on Sundays. He's probably a little bit racist. He's your grandpa, and he's about to wrestle a bear in defense of your grandma's good name. Good luck, buddy. Too bad. The bear submits Rogers via bear hug. 11 minutes, 44 seconds for a 77% rating. Decent showing by Rogers. He may need to wait for the Sloan title to move to a different competitor before he has a legitimate shot at claiming that belt. The Bear is just at the top of her game. Very difficult to beat. Our next match sees Bull Nakano take on Hiroyoshi Tenzan for the Abbotsford Championship. The Abbotsford title is the most storied title in all of World Peace Pro. Its inaugural holder, Death Yama-san, dropped the title to Tenzan in Season 1. There's no surviving footage, unfortunately. Tenzan would successfully defend the title at Grizzled Season 2 against Hollow Wicked before being forced to vacate the title after a season-ending injury at the hands of Natsuko Tora. The Bear would then defeat Tora to claim the vacated title and would defend it against Rojo Jr. and a returning Death Yama-san before losing the title to R-Truth at Knuckleberry Jam Season 3. Truth would retire at the end of that season and the title became vacant once again. Rojo Jr. would then claim the title in a match against ACH and defend it against Kongo Kong at Kentucky Knuckleberry Jam Season 4. Tenzan would be reunited with the belt after a victory over Rojo Jr. at Flashing Lights of this season, and we saw at our last event, Tenzan fended off a challenge by Bam Bam Bigelow. Bull Nakano is one of our most feared competitors, and a win here would move her into first place overall in the standings. Squashed Tenzan in 6 minutes 51 seconds. It was a squash. Striking Lariat 57%. Tenzan put up a fight early, but Nakano just took over and did not look back. She is your new Abbotsford champ. Our penultimate match of the evening, Tom Nakano attempts to lure Vikingo away from Dog Vision and into her yet-to-be-named stable. Will we have a new stable, or will it be back to the drawing board for Nakano? Let's find out. Vikingo injured by a sonic boom cuts the match short. 8 minutes and 22 seconds. I guess a 58% just due to injury. Oh, they were just getting warmed up. Oh well. The Kentucky Knuckleberry Jam strikes again. That's why we do it. This does go down as a victory for Tom Nakano, so that means Vikingo has left Dog Vision behind and will join forces with Tom under her new stable, which I think should be called Sonic Boom after what just happened. So we're going to call it Sonic Boom. A tag team title attempt would be a nice next move for these two. But we'll see what happens at Flex Parade. Also, now that Nakano has achieved her goal, she'll need a new focus. So let's get the dice of fate ready here. Nakano's next goal is to... Okay. Lead her stable to a winning season. That makes sense. Natural progression there. You know what? Let's quickly compare all of our stables and see how they are doing against one another. So Coco Express is the top spot at the moment, followed by Dog Vision. The newly created Sonic Boom is in third, Ryubone, and then the Market, and of course our Enhancement Talent Squad. The stable that ends the season with the highest winning percentage gets a bunch of fun bonuses, but we'll wait until our off-season special to talk about all of that. All right, on to our main event of the evening. Former member of the Market Stable, Bryant Big Country Reeves, coming for Warren Buffett's Kelowna Championship. The market's momentum sits at negative 11, but because Buffett is a stable leader, his wins and losses have doubled the effect on his stable's momentum, so if he can win this match, he'll successfully maneuver the market's momentum back to negative 9, and they will be safe for one more week. However, if he loses this match, they will end the night at a negative 13 and will be thrown into crisis mode. It's a high-stakes match. It took not one, not two, but three brain-buster lariats to keep Warren Buffett down for the count. Reeves is your new Kelowna champ in 10 minutes, 55 seconds, a 75% rating. The market is in crisis. If we check our Season 5 standings, we'll see that Bull Nakano has moved into first place overall after adding the Abbotsford title to her collection. The Bear is not far behind. Our match of the evening goes to Cobra Moon and Taiji Ishimori. They will have top priority for opponents at our next event, Alex Parade. Ishimori and Cobra Moon will have top booking priority. The Ferris Championship was vacated due to injury, so expect that to be fought over. Nyla Rose will put her World Peace Pro career on the line. Warren Buffett and the Bear will wrestle for leadership of the market stable. And our main event is the Flex Parade itself, the WPPW Royal Rumble, the winner of which will join Tom Nakano in the last dance for a shot at the Season 5 Grand Champion. Lots of exciting stuff ahead. Thank you so much for watching. Give the video a like if you liked it. You can subscribe if you want to follow along. Next week is Flex Parade. Very excited to find out what happens next. And that's it. World peace.